Welcome again. Right now we're at Philippians chapter 3, verses 1 through 5. Paul identifies as a Pharisee. Paul writes, "Finally, my brothers, rejoice in the Lord. To write the same things to you, to me, indeed, is not tiresome, but for you it is safe. Beware of the dogs. Beware of the evil workers. Beware of the false circumcision. For we are the circumcision who worship God in spirit and rejoice in Christ Jesus and have no confidence in the flesh, though I myself might have confidence in the flesh. If any other man thinks that he has confidence in the flesh, I yet more, circumcised the eighth day, of the stock of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew of Hebrews, concerning the law, a Pharisee." Paul says he's a Pharisee. Now, a lot of Christians today, they use the name Pharisee in a very bad light, okay? They call people Pharisees if, you know, someone says that what they're doing is wrong. You know, if someone points out your sin, you know, oh, you're a Pharisee. Oh, you're self-righteous. You know, don't be a Pharisee. And Phariseeism and all this kind of stuff. But do you realize that there are good Pharisees? Not every Pharisee was a bad Pharisee. Now, we know that Jesus did generally speak against the hypocrisy of Pharisees. That's not to say that there was not any Pharisees that were good, okay? We've got, for example, Paul here is a good example. And we've got other Pharisees that weren't that bad, okay? I mean, they weren't to be, you know, shunned or ignored or just, you know, completely cut out of your life. For example, Luke chapter 11, Jesus actually was invited to a Pharisee's house and he went to the Pharisee's house to have a meal, okay? So he went to hang out with the Pharisees. Now, some people even believe that Jesus himself was a Pharisee. And the reason why they believe that is they say, well, the Pharisees were so exclusive, they wouldn't hang out with anybody but their own kind. And Jesus hung out with them. I mean, Jesus was around the Pharisees a lot. He went to their homes, okay? So some people believe that Jesus was a Pharisee. Now, I'm not saying that Jesus was, or I'm not saying that he wasn't, okay? The Bible is not clear in this regard. However, we know that Paul identifies as a Pharisee. Paul did not say, oh, I used to be a Pharisee, but I repented of my Phariseeism, and now I'm a Christian. No, he said, I am a Pharisee. He made it present tense. Don't forget that next time you are tempted to call someone else a Pharisee. It could just be a compliment. Until next time, seek God with all your heart, and if you do, you will find him. Call upon him, and he will show you great and mighty things. Love you guys.